Hello everyone, this is Val from Val's Craft Creations, and today I am bringing you another project. This is a design team project for Lilifee the Paper Wish, and this paper is a collaboration with John Jonah Craft Lina. So this paper is a collaboration between John Jonah Craft Lina and Lilifee the Paper Wish. So the name of this paper collection is Roses Mon Amour. Hopefully I pronounce it right. It only bring six pages of like decorative paper and four pages of ephemera. You see a lot here because I printed twice my paper. I printed six on cardstock and six on regular copy paper because, you know, since I don't have a lot of pages and I don't know yet what I'm gonna do. It's kind of an album, John Journal. I don't know how to call it. I don't even have an idea yet on how I'm gonna work it, but let me show you this beautiful paper. You have a rose fairy here, or lady, I don't know. It don't have wings, but it's right there. Look how beautiful this paper is with this bird, the butterfly, the roses. This is very shabby chic. Look how pretty, rose collage. That's another one. Look at the butterfly here. I think this is the last one. Let me see. No, one more. And this is the last one. I also, this is just the copy paper. I also have some pink cardstock just in case I need to do some extra stuff. And let me show you some of the ephemera. I already cut it. It had tags. I use my the scissors and cut the top of my tag so it look irregular because I wanted to look that way. More tags. You have journaling cards. It has two envelopes, which are here. And this is, I forgot the name of this, but you use it to put like ribbon around it, a ribbon spool, I think it is. And then I'm gonna be using this box as my cover. This is gonna go inside. I'm gonna show you how we're gonna do that. I also have, I think this is D-dye paper that I'm gonna be using as pages. I have five copy paper folded in half. Because I have an idea, but I don't know yet what I want to do. I also have this lace, this doily, and more of this lace, different colors. I'm not going to use the black, but I have white and pink here and cream. Because my idea was, I'm going to cover this. Let's say I cover, this is just an example, using this paper, right? And then I was thinking to cover my paper outside with lace. And I like this one that has gold details, but I don't know. Because if I wanna use lace, I have more like cream color lace and trim than white. This is another lace that I have. So I don't know if I'm gonna cover this on top of my paper like that, or I also was thinking to do like a window here on my cover, and then instead of using film, using my lace as the window, you know, decorating the window instead of clear film, using the lace. But I don't know, I'm so confused. I know that I want to use my doily, like on the spine. Let me see, where is it? And this doily is kind of a cream color. I was thinking to use this like that on the spine. So I don't know what we're gonna come up with, but we're gonna do the base and then I will decide. But I think I'm inclining myself more to the window in the front. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. So let's get started. Okay, so this here, we're gonna have the pages attached to this. And we're gonna have 5 pages on this side, 5 pages on the other side. So this is gonna go like this. So I'm gonna attach them with the tape. I have to cut the paper to size. And that's gonna go here in the middle. And that's gonna be my pages. Here I'm gonna cover this with a piece of this paper. And then I will put pockets. And that's my idea. It's like kind of a album journal. And then the page that we're gonna see through the window. I don't know which one it's gonna be, but I'm gonna pick something that we can see on that window. Maybe this lady. Or because when I don't know, this lady is too to the side. But I will decide, don't worry. Maybe roses we're gonna see, or maybe this rose collage thing. Let me see. Maybe this one, the birdie. I don't know yet, but we will figure it out. Let's work on the base and then we will come up with an idea. So I'm gonna move all this to the side. And let's work on the base. I'm gonna give you measurements right now. Okay, so you're gonna need a cereal box, any box, cracker box that you have, or maybe a file folder. And this is gonna be, let me see if I have my scissors. It's 14 inches long by 8, but when you close the spine is 2.5, and when you close this, it's gonna be 8 by 6. So your journal is gonna be 8 by 6 with a spine of 2.5. And then you're gonna need for the center, I already put a piece of my paper. To add your pages, you're gonna need 5 pieces of cardstock. And they're gonna be 3.5, I think it is, by 8. Yeah, 3.5 by 8, and then I score and 3/4 of an inch, turn it around and score again at 3/4 of an inch, and I put double-sided tape on each side of this flap because that's how I'm gonna attach my pages to this. So if we go with the window, let me draw the window here. Let me get a pencil. I think I'm gonna go with the window, that way I don't waste that much lace. So we know that this is 8. Let me mark 4 here for now. And I know this is 6. And 3, so here's my middle. Didn't do anything with this pencil. So let me think how many inches I want around my, because maybe I want more on the bottom. So let's see, maybe 1.5. I'm just marking here real quick, 1.5 from each side. Cause I don't know how big I want my window. So let me measure this real quick and see how big I want my window. So that's 1.5. I'm gonna go right now 1.5 around. But on the bottom, I don't know if I'm gonna do 1.5 or if I want more space. My ring light, it's not working, and I feel like my room is so dark. So let me see, because 1.5, my window looks kind of small. If I go 1.5 on the bottom, let me see. So this will be my window, but I feel like it's kind of small, but I think I'm gonna go with it and see. I'm gonna cut it 1.5 around, and if I want more space like here, I will cut more later, but we're gonna do 1.5 around right now. Okay, let me get my cutting mat and a knife. And we're gonna cut that window. I always try to be as straight as possible. It's not always perfect, but I tried. Okay. Perfect, perfect. One more line. We're done. Well, for now, with the windows. I need to see where I gotta cut, because I don't want to pass my line. Okay, so let me put this knife away. So me see what lace I like on my window. Okay, we have, I'm between this one and the cream color one. I also have a pink, but I think since the paper have a lot of pink, I think. So what do you think? This one, maybe look at, on the camera, this one, or this one? I think I'm gonna go with this one. I'm not gonna think about it too much. So I'm gonna put, cover my window last. Let's do this because I can do this off camera. I just gotta put a rectangle of my fabric here, of my lace, and then I will cover this with paper. So, you know, that's easy. So let's work with this. That is not that easy. And I don't know if I should try to add the pages first and then this. Let's get the pages out. The reason why I printed some on cardstock and some on paper, copy paper, is because when I cover this, I always like to use better paper than cardstock, but that's up to you. And I wanted to use the cardstock as pockets. These pages, I'm gonna glue them, but I am not gonna use it as pocket because it's just copy paper. But these ones, I do want them to be more sturdy because I want them to be pockets on top. And let me see, now that we have the weave now. I wanna see if I fold the paper in half, what we're gonna see. This I had to cut some, so this one you hardly see anything. I may go with something like this. So I'm just folding my 5 pages cardstock in half and see what we're gonna be looking on that window. I kind of like this, and we can add some other stuff there. I think I'm gonna go more with something like this. Let me fold this one, the last one. Cause I wanted this here. So I think it doesn't matter what we're gonna see because we're gonna have that window. I can put something outside. So I think because of that, I'm gonna go with a simple paper like this. Yeah, I'm gonna go with something like this. It doesn't matter because I'm gonna decorate the outside. Maybe I can cut the rose fairy, or I don't know what it is. Where is it? That's the little girl. Here. Or I can cut this birdie and like, I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go with this. So this page I'm gonna put aside and we're gonna use fire the cardstock as pages and 5 of my tea dye paper. So let's do that now before we attach it here because I think it's gonna be easier. So let me show you my idea. see, the bottom one is the one that's gonna be showing. Okay, so we're gonna use this one on the first one that we're gonna glue down here. We're gonna use this one, and I want these roses on top. So let's remove this, the double-sided tape paper. And I'm gonna put some on my glue stick, because somebody told me once that if you put a little bit of this on top of your double-sided tape, you have more room to move the paper before, you know, that you can move it around a little bit instead of just taping it right there and then you're not able to move it. I think I have to cut this paper a little. Yep, I don't know why. So this is gonna be pockets. Where's my double-sided tape? This is gonna be the tedious part, you know, adding your pages to your journal, but just work it out. Let me put the glue. Let me remove this one here. I'm just doing this just in case I had to move it, but maybe we don't need to, but just to be on the safer side. And then let me cut this, because I thought that I cut my papers to the side, but it looks like maybe I didn't. Okay, so this is the one that we're gonna be seeing on this side. Now I have to decide which one is gonna go on this side. And I want cardstock on the beginning and at the end. So I think I'm gonna go with this simple one. Yeah, let's go with that one. I wish I had double-sided tape more wider than this one, but I don't have. Make sure. Wait, did I put this? Oh my goodness, what I did. The pocket is up here. So I had to turn this around. Because if we put it like this, the pocket is gonna be down here, so, but that's fine. We will work it out. Right there, my pocket is right here, so I have to make sure. Well, now I know, because the pocket is there, my goodness. And you saw me doing that and you didn't say anything? It's okay, it's okay. It's not the end of the world, right? I don't know if this video is gonna have one or two parts. Hopefully it's one. But you know, you get the idea. I'm gonna do one more of this page with the copy paper. And that way I will continue off camera. That way we don't take too long. But I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. And then you continue doing the other pages. And I'm gonna cut my other pages because apparently I didn't measure them. I was supposed to cut it to 8 inches long. So you're just gonna fold your paper in half and then cut 8 inches long. And don't do like me. And what you're gonna do is, let me make sure that my pocket is off here. Yes. Yes, it is. And then, yes, it is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna glue this down to this. And you're gonna continue doing the same thing and gluing this down in the middle with all your pages. It's that easy. So let me glue this one down. Make sure pockets are on top. Yes, I'm traumatized now. I need to get a new glue. I don't have a lot of this one. That's why I was saying that if I had a wider double-sided tape, I will use it here instead of my glue, my liquid glue. I'm running out of glue. Okay, so let me make sure that we place this. We have the same space on both sides. And you're gonna continue doing the same thing with your pages, but we're gonna alternate. On the next one, we're gonna use copy paper. And I'm not gonna seal top and bottom. I'm just gonna, you know, glue it down here and that's it. I don't care, maybe I can use this as a hidden something and put something inside that I can get in and out, up on top or down. So, but I don't want to glue all the paper. I just gonna, let's do one of these ones here. And I'm gonna do the same thing. Copy paper, and then the next one, it will be the cardstock. Okay, so let me see. This one have a little bit of blue. I don't mind, because you see there's some blue in some places, so let's do one of these ones and then I will do everything off camera. When I'm done with the pages, I'm gonna cut everything else for the cover and then, you know, I will come back and show you and we will continue working with the other steps. That glue is very sticky. Sure, I think my copy papers are larger than these ones. Yeah, but that's fine. I don't mind seeing some of this. Or maybe I will cut it and I have paper on this side and I don't know, let's see. Just thinking out loud here. If I figure out something else, I will let you know when I come back. I'm just mumbling. Okay, so I'm gonna continue working with this. I'm gonna cut this and Welcome back. Okay, so welcome back to my messy desk. So let me show you what I did. I just covered my journal with the paper. I don't mind that some of the blue or the thing is showing because we're gonna cover that with this. And I went ahead and cover the inside. I had to trim this a little bit here, but I will do that later when I finish. And I covered the inside. I finished putting the pages on the end. I decided to put, you know that I was alternating. I decided to put more of the copy paper here, because that way you have more journaling space, but that's up to you. I like it like that. You can change it. I'm sorry, I'm off camera, wait. You can change it if you want to, and also cover this here and the back. So what we're gonna do now is embellish this and cover the spine. I was thinking that I may wanna do a closure like this. It's gonna show like that, but I'm not gonna glue this here. I'm just gonna glue it on here on the spine, so when you open it, you don't have this cover. You will have a cover when, you know, you're not using your journal, but I don't mind that. If you mind it, then don't do this. I was thinking also do a double closure with two ribbons, like on top. I may do that, like here and on the bottom. That way, it will look more girly. I don't know. I will see. But another thing that I want to do is on the paper, that is the cardstock that we have pockets here on the top, I want to put lace, not on the copy paper, just on the cardstock. And I think it's only going to be 1, 2, 4 pages. So we're going to go ahead and put the lace right there. And the reason why is because this paper is smaller than the copy paper, and that way it will look more even out. Then for here, I didn't do it right now, but I'm gonna do it later, but I just want to let you know I'm gonna do, I have some large index card that I'm gonna create a jumbo journaling card, or maybe I will use some of this pink cardstock that I was using at the beginning and do and cover the front with these extra pieces that I have. So I only need 4 of the paper, so I have more here that I can cover my journaling cards. So I was thinking to do that, and so I'm gonna have 4 jumbo large journaling card on these pockets that we have. We have 4. Okay, so but right now we're gonna cover the border of this with my lace. Oops. Hopefully my glue won't dry and take him too long to put this. And let me, ouch, I almost got my finger. Well, I almost did. I catch my finger with my scissors, oh my goodness. Right there on camera. Oh my goodness, but that's fine. It's okay. I didn't do anything to my finger. Just be careful when you're crafting. Okay, so that's one. This is the next one. And I only gonna do it on one side, not on the back. This paper is so pretty. I love it. I love paper that has roses and the pink. I don't know, it's so pretty. These ladies are so talented. I created 4 digital paper, but I haven't released them. I released 2 a long time ago, but I fixed them. It's just that I haven't had a time. I've been so busy, I haven't had a chance to, you know, put it on my store. And my store is closed right now because I sold a lot of the stuff that was on my store. So I need to add new inventory to my store. But I haven't had a chance. Since I'm going to Puerto Rico, my country, for vacation, I guess I will work on my store like when I come back. Okay, one more. It's looking so pretty. Last one here. I think I am using my lace upside down. Now I notice it, but that's fine. If that bothers you and something like that happened, you can use a trim on top of this. Let me show you what I mean. Let me see if I have a trim. I may do it, I may not. This is too big, but if you have a trim like this, you can do it like that. You know what? It looked pretty. I'm gonna do it. Not because I put it upside down, because I really don't mind that. But it kind of looked pretty. Let me put the lace away. So we have some work space free here. Look, it looks amazing. Okay, let me make sure that this is not upside down. But like right there, look how pretty. We're gonna go with it. On this page, this is an album, so you can put pictures and write notes like on the copy paper pages. But I think I'm gonna do maybe pockets and stuff. But it's up to you. I always tell you, you know, I give you an idea and then you do, you know, what you like. I always like to leave things simple in case that somebody else get this and they can decorate it, you know, the way they want. It's so pretty. I love it. Do these ones. I think I may need some to put some glue. So I'm gonna do off camera the jumbo cards for my pockets. And then cause that way you will have more journaling space, more to you know, other places to journal instead of just these pages. My daughter got home. Hopefully she will remember that I'm recording because I sent her, she was at work. So I sent her a text, I'm gonna be recording, please. We are done decorating those pages. Oh my god, I had glue all over my nails and everywhere.
my god. Look how pretty it's looking so far. Look. I love it. I love it. I love it. Okay. So now, before we add this, we're going to add the ribbon. Hopefully, I have enough of this ribbon to do the closure. But I think I want to go shorter than this, maybe. I think that's good enough. And let me cut another piece. I was gonna do one, but let's do two. Two ribbons. I need to get more of this. This is organza. But I want to get the a different, you know, not as wider as this one. Less wider, I guess what you will say. Okay, I'm gonna put, I'm running out of this one. I need to get more. Okay, so I'm gonna find, let me measure this here again. I don't know, my camera looks like I'm off. I don't know. Like I know where my camera is, not where I always have my camera. I think that's what I mean. I feel like it's out of place. Like it's too low here and then like I'm off camera. I don't know. I don't wanna move it. I'm just gonna finish recording like that. Like, I don't want to. Move my ribbon. Now I can release it. Okay, now the other side. Let's measure this here. I guess it doesn't matter because we can cut it off, but okay, perfect. I'm not gonna cover this yet. Maybe in the back if you want to, but I think I'm gonna leave it like that. So now we're gonna cover. Let me see if I can stand this here so I can work this. I think that's good enough, I guess. Here we have the window, so I think that's good. I think I'm gonna cut that. no sé quién, it was maybe my liquid glue, but it's easier and faster with the glue gun. And it's clear, so you're not gonna see it. Perfect. And then I had this thing. You can remove the glue a little. I think this is for, how you call that, for face, to apply face mask. I found that at Dollar Tree. But I like this one because I have one that is purple here and it's not the same. It has to be the clear one. I think let's glue this ribbon just there. Just because I think it's gonna be easier to work this out here. I applying the glue to the doily because I don't know where my flower of the doily is gonna hit, and I don't want to put a lot of glue and then, you know, the doily will not cover it. I got this doily on an antique mall. I think it was like $3. They're perfect. Let's go to the other side. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna glue the ribbon in place there. This is so pretty. I don't know how long this tutorial is gonna be, but hopefully this video won't be that long. I don't know how long I took on the first part when we were starting, but hopefully it's no more than an hour, or maybe closer to a little bit more than an hour. You know, when I start making videos at first, oh my God, I have so many first part, second part, three part videos, because I was doing everything on camera, even cutting the paper. I wanted everybody to see the process, right? I think on the back, I don't know, I have a misfeeling if I want it like this. Let's leave it like this, but I think on the back, since we're not gonna decorate anything, we can hold the ribbon in place. It's looking so pretty. I don't even want to cut this doily, but I have to. I guess I will cut it. So let me get my fabric scissors. So pretty. This is a crime. But, you know, you have to do what you have to do. Can use this on something else. Like, I can use these as scraps. Perfect, it's looking good. Then when I put the journaling cards here, I wanna use some of this organza or some lace, and then you will see all those like the ribbon on top. It's gonna look so girly. Okay, I had this flower, but I don't know if I'm gonna use it. I have it there. I cut some pieces here. Trying to see what I like. I wanted this on the bottom. I may put this on the back. Let me see. This one I think I'm gonna need to cut because I needed to put this before this and I forgot. So, and I don't know if I want to cover. Let me see if I can. Can't remove it. I wish the paper, and I'm gonna put this here. Nah, no, 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 no. Okay, I was thinking if I use. Like some flowers like that. Let me get my flowers. That will help me decide. And I guess some similar colors. That's too dark. Maybe, maybe. Bear with me for a moment. Here's the package that I was looking for. I think that's the one that I wanted. Let's see. Okay, I like that. Like that there. Liking that. I wanted to use the little birdie, but I don't know. I think I'm gonna use this as decoration somewhere else, but I like this, so let's go. Let's go with this. I think I'm gonna use my liquid. I'm running out of glue. Okay, let me see if I remember how to play. Yeah. I needed to put it down here, but let me see, maybe a butterfly right there. Yep. Then this, because this is gonna go here. Wait, let me, I think I'm gonna move this flower a little bit lower. I like that. Then maybe I should just, I'm thinking if I should just put the ribbon. This is, you know, let me see if I can remove this. I think my glue is already dry. I'm gonna try to be careful. You know, you're allowed to change your mind. It's just that I think my ribbon would be better if I place it already. Yeah. Than disturbing my stuff. Wait, let me. Guess it's gonna be disturbing my peace. Okay, now my leave, we'll go back. My God, please, I need to finish recording. Please, glue, work with me. I definitely need to get a new one. I don't even know if I got something out, but I think I did. Oh yeah, I love it. I think I'm happy now. Okay, where's my other butterfly? I want to put. Yeah, I like it up there. Then here, I don't think. I need like another smaller flower. I think I'm gonna leave it like this, but where's my bird? Yeah, I think I had to go with the original idea of this bird being on the cover. Oh, I love it. Okay, so on this side to cover, where's the other one? Now this one has to be like on this side. Let's see. I had to trim this. Forgot. I would this flower like look like they're there together, but let me see about them. I don't like that. Wait, I have to go lower. I'm not gonna damage my paper, but that's fine. Let me. Let me go lower because, and I think I'm gonna cut this here. Just trying to see that you don't see that much of the white on the other side. I have this. Yeah, but I will put a sentiment or something. I haven't bring anything to put there. So I think that that's good enough. Inside, I'm not gonna put something bulky. Perfect. That's good enough. Oh, my glue gun is turning off. My goodness. It's so pretty. Okay, so I think I'm gonna leave it like this. Let's close it. I'm gonna add all this extra stuff later on, but you know, you got the idea, the base and everything. I may do like this here and put something here. And then decorate some of these ones like this. I gonna leave like that. This one. Maybe this one. And then these plain ones, I think I'm gonna add pockets or something. But you get the idea, this is the base. Let's close it. Because I don't want to take too long, and you already know, you know, how to decorate your themes. Trying to, when it's small things like this, always, it's hard for my hands. So pretty. So when I turn off my camera, I'm just gonna continue adding, gonna create some pocket, gonna create the journaling cards. It's better if I go this way. Maybe did I cut this too small? But I don't want it to be that long either. Just on my hands. And then open your ribbon like this. I will fix it when we're done, but look how pretty it is. I think I want this to be a little longer, but look how pretty. Oh my God, I love it. So pretty. And that's the inside, and that's the cover, front cover, and the back. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Remember, the paper name is, where's my, here it is, Roses Mon Amour. I think that's the way you say it. And it's a collaboration with Lily Fide Paper Wish and John Joyner Craft Lina. I'm gonna leave the information on the description box. You will get a discount. Lily Fide always have a discount on her store. I don't have the paper right now. I have it, but I don't know where I put it, and I forgot to tell you at the beginning, but I will leave it on the description box. I hope that you have enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment. Sometimes, if you follow me on Facebook and you see that my comments are off, leave me a message over there letting me know, because I don't know why YouTube keep turning my comments off. But thank you for watching, everyone. Happy crafting.